Well, what a happily married couple. With a big house, a great job, and a wonderful family decide to leave it all and move their 7 kids, their 2 dogs, and their turtle into a 360-foot camper and travel the world full-time? It's because they're crazy. But today we're going to talk about how that looked for us and how that might look for you.
So in our last video, we told you that there are 3 questions that no matter where we go or what we're doing, when we show up in our RV with all the kids, the dogs, and the turtle, we get 3 questions that everyone wants to know. So we thought while we're here, settled in one place during the quarantine, we would answer some of those questions. And the first question is, why? Why would you do that? Why would you move all your kids in to an RV and travel the country? The second question is how? How do you do it? How do you live in that space with so many people moving all the time? And the last question is what? What did you do to prepare and to get ready for this epic adventure with its ups and downs? How did you get prepared for that adventure? So today we're going to be answering question number 1, which is why? Why did we do this?
Well, for our family, it started on date night. Date night has been an important part of our life for a really, really long time. Once a week, we would go out to dinner and enjoy that time together. And during one of these times, we were eating. We were actually in the downtown square, the little town that we're in, great restaurant. We were sitting outside, which is one of our favorite things to do. Little table for 2, and we were just talking as we normally do.
Kind of like right now.
Yep. And we were at a transition time at my job, and so we were talking about some bigger picture issues than what we normally would talk about. And as we were talking about that, we decided that the Lord was leading us to a change, that it was time for us to change jobs. And so we thought, well, maybe let's take this opportunity between these 2 jobs and let's have a little fun. Let's take a little trip. One of the things that we have wanted to do for 20 years is get back to Yellowstone National Park. Yeah. We went there 20 years ago. We were only a few years married. We took a group of teenagers on a mission trip, and we spent 24 hours in Yellowstone on the way back as a reward. And ever since then, we have wanted to get back. And that's only national park that we'd ever been to.
Yeah.
And so when we talked about where we wanted to go, we immediately knew that that's what we want to do. If we take a little trip between these 2 jobs, let's do that. Well, when you got a big family like we do, little things are not ever little things. And so as we started to talk about, well, what would that really look like? Would we try to fly everybody? Well, that's a lot of plane tickets. Well, would we try to drive the whole way? Well, that's a lot of in and out of hotels. Well, would we maybe rent an RV? And so we pulled out our phones right there, and I started crunching some numbers on some rental things and some miles, and it was going to be like $14,000 to rent an RV for like 8 days to go out there and back.
Not including the gas and the food and all the other stuff that you want to do.
So I said, well, good gracious, if we're going to pay that much to rent it, we'll just buy one. And Francis said, really? And that was what started it. So we said, well, gosh, if we bought an RV, then we would want to see more than one national park. Well, gosh, if we did that, then it's going to take more than a month. And one thing led to another, and by the time we got up from the table, we had decided that in about 9 months, we were going to leave everything, move into an RV, and for 18 to 24 months, we were going to travel around and see every continental national park. And it was just as crazy as it sounded, but we were both at absolute peace about it. I mean, literally from the moment we got it from that table. We never looked back. We knew it was
huge,
the right thing.
Because Jay and I are very different people. So I am adventurous and excited and spontaneous and maybe don't think through things very well. And he is the opposite of that. He is an executive pastor, so he thinks through every detail, crosses every T, dots every I. So for the two of us, which are on 2 different sides of the spectrum, to be at peace in just that first moment was absolutely a miracle. And we knew when that happens, something's up with that for sure. Absolutely. And so that's kind of our why. That's why we first started this journey. But you know what? It has taken lots of twists and turns. It's changed a lot. It isn't exactly like we thought it would be on that first date night. Things have really grown. Things have had to be changed. Reality has hit in different ways. And time frames were a little bit fluid at times. But for us, that is the why. It's just we knew that this was something that we were supposed to do, and we just wanted to follow God into this crazy adventure. But you know what? It might not be that for you. You know, it might not be that you're supposed to move into an RV and tour around the United States. There might be something else that you really feel called to do, something that's tugging on your heart. I had a friend, and he was saying, man, I just really wanted to do this, and was unhappy where he was. And we kind of found ourselves going, well, why, what would you do? And why are you staying where you are? And why wouldn't you move to what it is that you really love to do? And the more we've met people, the more we've seen that other people have something hidden in their heart, something deep within them that they feel like maybe God's calling them to, but the normal thing of life is just getting in the way. And so we want to encourage everybody to ask the question of why in your life. Why are you doing what you're doing? Okay. Why is your normal? And then why aren't you doing whatever it is you feel like God has called you to, even if it is crazy, absolutely crazy. And so that's why this question was so important. It's where it all began. And I think it really starts, everybody has to start with why. Why would you do this? And why aren't you doing this?
Well, I think for many of us, we get so comfortable with our day-to-day routine, even if we hate our day-to-day routine, we're so comfortable in it that we don't want to get out of that. We don't want to push out of that. And when we see somebody pushing out of it, we say, well, gosh, they are crazy. Well, the reality is sometimes we need a little bit of that crazy in our lives.
That's right.
And this is what that crazy looks like for us.
Right.
But there has to be a deeper foundation for us. We are right. Christians. We have a deep faith. Yes. And so there needed to be something more than just a crazy adventure to found this on. And so for us, that really shaped up, the more we talked about it, it shaped up to be three pillars, faith, family, and fun.
Yeah.
And as we talked about that more, we realized that, you know, that's not something that's isolated to a 2-year RV adventure. That's something that needed to be there all of the time in our lives, and something that needed to be there all the time, really, in a lot of people's lives.
Yeah.
And so then we decided, well, gosh, those really are the things that we should found this on, and then we could share those with other people. And so that's really what all of our YouTube channel, everything's going to be based around, is faith, family, and fun. The biggest of those is crazy faith. And I've kind of already talked about that a little bit, that we all need to push outside of our box. We all need to have a little bit of a crazy adventure. And sometimes that may be just taking a weekend off from work and doing something abnormal. It may just mean locking your whole family in your house for 2 days and enjoying one another.
Getting off your screens and getting outside.
It can look like a lot of different things.
Take up a new hobby, hiking, you know, anything. Just something to get out of your regular day-to-day ho-hum.
But we feel like having that faith is so critical. Again, for us, the Bible teaches in Hebrews 11 that without faith it's impossible to please God. And I think that's because God wants to see us pushing outside of the things that we can do ourselves. And that means for us as Christians, pushing into the things that we have to lean into Him for.
Right.
Doing something like this is not anything we could ever do on our own. But we know that if we lean into God, that He's always going to be leaning back. That we can never get so big that it's bigger than something He can handle. And so for us, that's a huge part of this journey and our reasoning for it.
Right. But it also had to include our family, because family is the second thing that is super important to us. And our family is a larger family than most people's. And so for us, it was going to have to include all of them at their different ages and stages, backgrounds, different, I guess, fitness levels as well, but also ability levels, because we have special needs in our family. And so we really wanted to make sure that this was going to work for our family and including everybody, and for that to be a big part of what we do. And so we're going to be sharing a little bit about what our tips and tricks are for raising a family that is connected. What does that look like? No matter if you have grown children who are almost getting married in that stage of life, or whether you have little ones who are 8 and 9 years old in elementary school, or even if you're raising children who are not typical, who have different special needs and things like that. And so we're going to be sharing apps that we love, maybe recipes that we like that we found really are crowd pleasers for our big crowd. We're also going to be sharing just different maybe websites, different things that our kids, their stories, a little bit about what who they are, how they came to our family, just different things about our family. And we really wanted this journey to really incorporate everybody in their level and in their way. And so we want to be able to share that, because for me, it was really important as we began this journey, we really connected with families who shared about what worked for them, what didn't work for them, strategies and tips. I'm always reading, I'm looking at podcasts, trying to find ways for our family to be better connected, to love each other more, to bear with each other more, to learn more together, and to be stronger. And so that's what we want to do, is also learn that, but also share some of that as well.
Yes, we feel like, I mean, family is just hugely important. That's why it's one of our pillars. I mean, we feel like really honestly, family is one of the first things in the Bible that God created. After he created man, the next thing he created was a family. He brought a woman and brought them together as a family. And so that's something that it's a huge priority, and not just our family, but family, that family unit. That's the reason we got into foster care, is to help those that didn't have that family. And so we feel like that's really, of all these pieces, is the one that can translate to the most people, because it doesn't matter what stage you're in, whether you're single and you're just an aunt, or you're a husband and wife, you're newlywed, or you've got kids, or you've got grandkids. This, whatever that family looks like for you, we feel like that's hugely important, and so that's hugely important to us. And of course, every family's crazy. You know, we like to say normal's just a setting on the dryer. Our family looks way different, but your family looks way different too. Right. Every family's got their unique bend. And so not only crazy faith, crazy family, but finally crazy fun. We feel like that is that must-have aspect of all of this. The reality is, it doesn't matter how far you push out of your comfort zone into trusting in God. If you're not having fun in that, you're not going to do it for very long. Right. It doesn't matter what focus you're putting on your family, what things you're changing, what things you're trying to implement. If the family's not enjoying it, it's not going to last for very long. And so fun is a huge part of this. It's what really kind of holds all those other pieces together and makes just this journey worth doing. And so if anybody knows our family, they know that I'm not the fun one, Francis is. And so I'm going to let her share
it's
more
true.
About that.
It's a true story. Yeah, so I love fun and enjoy laughing and having a great time. I also like to have fun with my family and create memories, different opportunities to do something a little bit out of the ordinary, something that we look back at pictures, we look back at video, and it spurs conversation. It's just a family fun opportunity to do something a little bit different. I have found when we plan for fun activities, when we plan fun into our lives, we're much more likely to get off our screens. Where if we get out of the house, if we just go out for a walk, if we just take up maybe hitting a tennis ball or throwing the ball for the dog today, if we just get out and do a few fun things, I have found we all are better for it. We all turn from the screen, from the TV, from work, and we turn towards our family and friends, to what is important, or just towards opportunities for us to grow as people, as family, as friends. And so we found that we just need to plan that. It needs to be an important pillar. And so for us, we're going to be documenting the fun that we have, not only for YouTube, but also for ourselves, so that we can look back, because you tend to forget all the fun things that you did and exactly where you were and what you were doing and what was the name of that hike and where were we that we had that great meal. We want to be able to document that for ourselves, but also to help you and your family and friends, or even just you by yourself, find some really amazing places around this gorgeous creation that God has given us, and be able to help you be able to take some fun to that next crazy level for you and your family.
So those are our three main whys. You know, again, that's a little bit of our story of kind of what started it, but we feel like those are the three pillars that really undergird this: having crazy faith, crazy family, and crazy fun. And those are also things that we feel like can translate to help you.
Right.
And so that's why we kind of started this YouTube channel, because we feel like even though these are the things we're focused on inside of our RV, as we're looking at national parks, there are things that can help every person out there. And so that's going to be the way that we structure our YouTube channel. We're going to try to do videos on each of those three things. on Crazy Faith. Francis and I are vocationally authors and speakers, and so we really want to communicate that, how God is growing us and what we're seeing Him do and what you could see Him do in that. We have a very unique family, a very big family, and so we've tried a lot of things that have really worked, and we've tried a lot of things that really haven't. And we're going to be trying more of those. And so we want to share some of those with you, the good and the bad, so that you can try them and see if they work for you. And then finally, the crazy fun. That's going to be the part as we're traveling around and looking at these parks again. The why is this faith, family, and fun. But the going to see all of the national parks is really kind of the peg holes that we're going to string all this thing around. And so we're going to be sharing those, not just the national parks, but even the state parks and the little hikes that we see being out so that you might find one. You might not try to see all of them like we are, but you might find one that you want to see. And so that's what we're going to be doing each and every week as we share this with you via YouTube.
That's right. And so speaking of YouTube and videos, I am really excited about the next two videos. Not just because I'm hosting them, but because they are the ones when I was starting out, I wanted to watch on other people's channels. So the first one is our RV reveal. What we've done to make this our home. Because really, if you're going to launch out, you know, there's a difference in weekending and living life. And so we want to show you kind of how we live in this. And that's the second question, is how. So we answered why today. And then the next question is how. How do we live with this many people in a 350 square foot home? Really, even if they're just have two kids. Just that's a how question that we want to answer. And so we're going to let you into our house, let you into our lives, and let you see kind of how it works out, where everybody is, how we are able to maneuver and live in such a small space. So we're going to let you in kind of inside our closed doors, because you always want to see how people are living, whether it's a huge house or just a little cabin, or if it's an RV. Everybody wants to see how everybody else is living, like we really do. And so we're going to let you in. We're going to invite you in just like you're our family, like you're our crazy family. You're going to get invited in to our space. Then I'm going to do another video. It's going to be broken into two parts. The how is, and the other one is how do we actually live day to day? Like, what's inside our closets? How in the world do you fit all your stuff, all your kids, two dogs and a turtle and all their stuff? Because I'm gonna tell you, Spikey the turtle is probably one of the most high maintenance people we have in our house. And so how do we live day to day? How does this work? And so there's gonna be organization. You're gonna see inside, how did we figure out what to bring and where does it all go? So those are the next two videos we're gonna be doing, and I'm super excited about that. And we would love your feedback on that, so you can kind of help us see what works for you and in your life, your crazy faith, your crazy family, and what kind of crazy fun you're having too.
And then I'll finish out kind of our question part with the what do we do to prepare? And so that'll be coming in just a few weeks. And so be on the lookout for those videos coming down the road. Don't forget to like this video and then subscribe so that you make sure that you don't miss anything. That actually helps us out a lot when you do those two things. And then also, if you missed our last video, just get some context on this one. You can click right down there and get it as well. And don't forget to follow all of our social media outlets. You can go to our website, which is www.findyourcrazy.org, and check out everything there. See you next time.